Today, we are going to discuss about the introduction to Java. So, introduction to Java programming. Java is one of the important language and is a very flexible language. Very easy to understandable. So lot of features are available in Java. Nowadays, in order to develop any particular application, that may be a mobile application or a web application, then lot of people are preferring Java programming language. Why? Because it is one of the strongest language. It has robustness. It has many features compared to other programming languages. Okay. So Java is object oriented programming. Object oriented programming. Object oriented programming. Object oriented programming representing what? In a sense, we can able to write the Java program with the help of objects. We can able to create the objects with the help of objects only. We can able to perform different tasks. So every instruction are made with the objects only. Basically, what is an object is? Object is a real-time entity. A real-time entity, it can be called as an object, like a living object or non-living things. Living things or non-living things can be considered as an object only. And the definition will be an object can be a real-time entity or an instance of a class. An instance of a class. So we can take any particular Java program. The Java program contains instructions, or all instructions are made with the help of objects only, and the program is also going to perform any particular task based on the objects only. So that's why Java can be called as a object oriented programming. And compared to the C and C++, which are nothing but procedural oriented programming language. Procedural oriented programming language. C is a structure oriented, C++ is a procedural oriented language. C is a structure oriented programming language representing we have to follow one particular structure. Based on the structure only we can able to write the C program. Coming to the C++, it is a procedural oriented programming language representing we can able to write the program with the help of some procedures. And in order to know the Java, we need to know about some things about C and C++. We need to know about the C and C++ features also. Based on the C and C++ feature only, we can able to understand Java in a quick way. Because in Java also, we can adopt the lot of concepts introduced by the C and C++, like arrays, strings, structures. Everything, lot of features are available in C and C++. Based on the features, we are going to adopt some content from the previous languages like C and C++. Okay. And next, who introduced Java? Java author is James Gosling. James Gosling is a person introduced by the Java in the year of 1995. And one of the company introduced to this kind of language, you can call it as a Sun Microsystem. And this can be maintained by Oracle. So this is a history of the Java. And next, initially the first name of the Java language is Oak, and after that Oak is replaced with the help of Java only. And it is not the first object oriented programming. Actually, the first object oriented programming is Scylla. This is a small history of the Java programming. Okay, so and with the help of Java programming, why we are going to prefer the Java programming? Because it contains lot of features. What are they? The features of the Java is, the first one is that it is simple. Why it is simple means we can write the program with the help of different instructions. Those instructions which are very understandable format. Okay. By seeing any single program, we can easily able to understand, because all are framed with the help of objects only, because objects are different, just like a pen, a bench, a pencil. With the help of those objects only, we can able to write the program. Okay, so that's a, that is the main reason only. Whatever the program that we have written in Java, that we can able to, that we can easily able to understand. That is the point. Okay, and it is a very simple language. Okay, and the second thing is, second feature is, it is platform independent. It is platform independent. Platform independent representing means, if you consider one operating system, for example, Windows. I am taking a Windows operating system. In that Windows operating system, I can write one Java program. And Java program will execute, it will provide some result. Okay. Similarly, I have taken another operating system like Linux. Same program I am going to write in Linux also. The same result will be produced. Representing what? Java can be suitable to any particular operating system. Irrespective of operating system, we can write the programs. Okay. One program that you have been developed. Okay. To perform a specific task to get some kind of results. That program, it can be suitable to any particular operating system. You can consider Windows, you can consider Linux, you can consider any other operating system. The program will be same. Okay, you are not, the irrespective of the operating system means operating system doesn't demand you whenever you are taking Java platform. And I will tell you another example also. For example, in C language, we are going to use the header files like hash include stdio.h or hash include pointer.h. Okay, to run the some CLR, SCR functions or getch function. I am taking hash include pointer.h representing this header file we are going to use in C language as well as a C++. And this header file is not supported in Linux. Okay. So here means what? This header file is not suitable to Linux, so you cannot use this header file. You cannot use this header file in the Linux side. And Linux can able to execute the C programs, obviously. But this header file you cannot include. So you are changing the program with respect to the operating system. But coming to the Java, we are saying the important feature, it is platform independent. It is platform independent means write once and run anywhere. Irrespective of the operating system, Java program will execute. That is one of the important feature. Platform independent. And the third one is it is portable. Portable representing it is suitable to any particular operating system. And fourth one, it contains robustness. Robustness means protection. So Java, it is very highly securable language, and every application that you have been developed with the help of Java, it is always having protection, good protection. That is nothing but robustness. Okay, every application are made with the robustness, so we are not worried about any malicious activities are happened to our application. Okay, whenever you are using Java platform. So these are the some important features: simple, platform independent, portable, and robustness. Okay, these are the main features of the Java language. Okay, and next, coming to the, we are saying Java is object oriented programming. Okay, why we are saying object oriented programming? Because we are having some OOPS concepts. That OOPS concepts are supported by the language called Java. That's why we are saying Java is a object-oriented programming. What are the OOPS concepts? Object-oriented programming system concepts. Okay, what are they? Any particular language, if suppose C or C++ or any other language which are supported by the OOPS concept, then that language we can call it as a object-oriented programming language. Of course, C++ also is a combination of the procedure-oriented language as well as the object-oriented programming language. Okay, and what are the main OOPS concepts of Java programming? The first one is a class. Second one is object. The third one is inheritance. Fourth one is polymorphism. Fifth one is encapsulation. And sixth one is a abstraction. These are the main OOPS concepts which are supported in Java. That's why we are saying Java is a object-oriented programming language. The first one is nothing but a class. Class is representing collection of objects. Okay, class is representing collection of objects or a template that is followed by the object. Okay, so and we are going to take the class. In the class only we are going to write our program. Whatever the implementation that you want to develop, you can implement in the inside of the class only. Every implementation, every coding part that we are going to representing in the object in the class only. Second thing is the object. To run our class we are going to create one object. Based on the objects only we are going to execute our methods, we are going to execute our logics. Okay, so because with the help of class and objects only our instructions are going to be made, which are very very important. And object definition of input, it's a real time entity or an instance of a class. These are the two things we need to know about it before programming. And coming to the next features, inheritance. It's one of the important concept. Inheritance of input, it's a mechanism. It is a mechanism which is used to acquire the properties of from one class to another class. Okay. And the inheritance main intention is code reusability. For example, if I am taking class calculator, here I am implementing some addition. Calculator containing some operation, automatic operation like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, everything we are going to implement. Now this is we have implemented, let us assume. And in the implementation side, I want to do I want to develop an advanced calculator that we can say is a scientific calculator like a CAL. Okay, a scientific calculator also support all automatic operation. Suppose assume that if we have already implemented a calculator, is there any possibility of using this kind of code, that this code can be useful in this class or not, we are going to verify. Whenever you are taking an inheritance concept, we can adopt this kind of code in this class. We can easily use this code in this class. No need to develop again the addition code, subtraction code, multiplication code. Okay, we just use the inheritance concept and we are going to take this code support and we are going to use this code in the scientific calculator also. Or addition to that, you can implement any other operations like remainder or percentile that you want to perform. Okay, like that. Okay, already the class is available, already the code is available. No need to develop it again. We are going to reuse this code into this class. That is the advantage of the inheritance. Okay, it's a simple example. Next one is a polymorphism. Polymorphism representing. Poly means many. Morphism means forms. Many forms. Many forms means one particular operation, if you consider. That we can perform in different ways. One operation we are going to perform in different ways. That representing what polymorphism. For example, I will say a plus operator. Plus operator is yes. Plus operator representing what? Addition only. Suppose if you place this plus operator in between two integers like a plus b, then it can be called as a addition. Suppose the same plus operator, if you representing in between two strings, str1 and str2, then representing what? Concatenation. String concatenation means combining two strings together. So plus operator, we are going to place in between two integers representing addition. The plus operator, you are representing in the form of in between strings representing concatenation. The same plus operator performing different operation. So it contains polymorphism. We can say that the property contains the place is going to perform it in different ways. We are replacing plus operator for addition as well as a concatenation. Okay. In normal example, generally a person can be a father in his home. A person can be an employee in his office, like that. One person can perform different, having different behaviors. Then that can be represented polymorphism. And polymorphism examples we are going to implement method overriding and method overloading, and as well as they are able to create virtual function, like that. So many examples are available for the polymorphism. Encapsulation means we can able to combine. We can able to combine code and data together into a single unit. We are saying Java is the strongest security language. How we are going to achieve this means by the help of encapsulation. Code and data together, we are going to place it in a single unit. Then it will give a security to our application. So that is the thing. So they are going to combine code plus data together. Then that representing what? Encapsulation. It will give a security to our application. Coming to the abstraction. Abstraction representation what? Showing abstraction representing hiding data. It's showing essential details but hiding implementation. Java is a securable language. Abstraction is also one of the important features. It will provide security. For example, you are using mobile apps. I want to play a game. Okay, you can download the game from the Play Store and you are going to play the game. And the game, it will show some instruction based on the instructions. Based on the instruction only you are going to play. But how it is happening in the background side, that you don't know that. Because the game developer cannot show you what kind of implementation is available for that game. They are going to show only essential details. So means what? Java can use one of the important features called abstraction. So these are the most concepts supported by the Java programming. That's why we are saying Java is a pure object-oriented programming. Okay.